New insight tonight on the man who set a new record, breaking the sound barrier by skydiving 24 miles, hitting speeds of more than 830 miles an hour from the edge of space. My interview with Felix Baumgartner in a moment, but first, a look at his historic jump.
Sometimes, you have to be up really high. The smaller you are, not going nowhere.
Jump away. And come home he did. We wanted to know what it was like up in the stratosphere, looking down at the Earth, knowing there's only one way home. I spoke to Fearless Felix earlier for the Big 360 interview. When you opened that capsule door and you were standing on the edge looking down, what is going through your mind?
Well, it was a very unique and outstanding moment because I've been working so hard for 5 years to reach that point, you know, and it was a beautiful view when you look out there. But at the same time, you realize that everything around you is hostile. Mm-hmm. Plus, when I disconnect my oxygen hoses from the ship system, I only breathe oxygen from my bailout bottles, and they only had 10 minutes, so there's not a lot of time to waste right on the exit point.
I read that if you had even gotten a tiny tear in your suit, that you could have died, that you could have been boiled alive. Is that true?
That's not true. I mean, I've been told if you have a hole the size of a dime, you know, it will still do the job.
What does it feel like to be traveling more than 800 miles an hour? Do you feel like you're traveling?
You feel you are fast because you accelerate so fast, but you do not feel that you're traveling at 830 miles an hour. Plus, you do not feel that you travel at supersonic speed because all my scientists before, they told me that you're going to have a shock wave going through your suit. I never saw it. I never felt it. And that supersonic boom happens way behind you.
It happens behind you. Do you notice anything when you're bringing
this? I have no reference at all. Until I opened my parachute, I did not know if I broke the speed of sound or not. So when I touched the ground with my parachute, I've been told by a lot of people on the ground, they heard that supersonic boom.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so it's the first and only supersonic boom created by a human person, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, to say the least. And then there's this incredible moment where you're spinning, and it seems like you're out of control. Were you actually out of control?
No, I knew from the beginning, or we knew from the beginning on, that you cannot go off stable because there's a lack
off
of
stable?
Air. Off, you cannot go off the capsule
okay.
stable.
You okay,
so
right.
when you step off, you're gonna spin. Yeah, that's a matter of fact. It's almost in a vacuum. There's no supportive air. And there's a well-trained skydiver use this air to stabilize yourself. But the first 30 seconds, you have no air. So the only way that you can do it is you spin. So now you have 50 seconds to control that spin, and you cannot practice this before because either you go for supersonic speed or not. So while you constantly spin, you have to figure out the solution how to stop that spin. So it was moving my arms and legs, but really gentle because you still keep in mind you're traveling at 830 miles an hour. So you cannot stick your arm out like this because then it becomes worse. Mm-hmm. So I was trying to figure out a way how to stop it. And once I had it, you know, I never lost it.
Are you thinking second by second? No time to really enjoy it, I guess, is there?
Oh, no. That was business, you know. As soon as you step off, it's
right.
business. Because, you know, you have been working so hard to accomplish what we have to accomplish, and there's no second thought about emotional stuff. You have to perform well.
Time-wise, did it go by really quickly, or do you remember every sort of second of it?
I remember every second. Uh-huh. You know, I was totally concentrated. I was focused, just trying to do the right thing.
Is there ever a moment of fear or worry?
Well, it's not fear because my life was never in danger. If it looks like that for regular people, we have been doing a lot of testing before, you know. We have developed a lot of safety equipment to make this as safe as possible. So my life has never been in danger. The only worry that I had is not breaking the speed of sound.
Also, your landing seemed perfect. I mean, you see people doing regular skydives and, you know, they collapse on the ground. Your landing was amazing.
I mean, I never thought about landing my whole life because it's a natural thing on a skydive. But this time I was too worried about falling down, you know, because the whole world was watching. So you want to finish this, you know,
you
want to
stick the landing.
Uh-huh. And that's why I was getting a little bit worried when I was 30 seconds prior to landing. I still didn't know where the wind is coming from because you have no flares out there, no nothing, and my helicopter guys were supposed to drop some flares. And 30 seconds before landing, I still didn't see flares. That's why I was yelling at the guys over my radio, drop some flares, because I want to know where the wind is coming from, because I want to finish this in a perfect way. And then finally, they dropped some flares. I could read the direction from the wind, and I landed on my feet.
I love that after all of the stuff you've gone through, the last 30 seconds, you're worried about looking good on the landing. That's you know, about finishing it well. I'd read also that you had panic attacks or a sense of claustrophobia in the suit. What was that like? What was that feeling?
Well, it happened in the beginning. You know, every time when I was in the suit for almost an hour, I kind of felt anxious, but I was fighting my way through. And then after all the tests that we did, there was this big chamber test at Brooks Air Force Base in San Antonio, Texas, and I was supposed to spend 5 or 6 hours in the capsule. We took that capsule, we put it in a chamber, they cooled it down to what we experienced up there. They brought me all the way up to 129,000 feet inside that chamber. Mm-hmm. And I knew this is a full dress rehearsal and it goes on for 6 hours. And I knew that I cannot do 6 hours in this suit. Hmm. So I had to address
it. Because it just, it's claustrophobic?
Yeah, when you put that visor down, you know, you're trapped in your own little world. Hmm. The only thing that you hear is your breathing for hours and hours and hours. And it's very stiff, so at altitude, it becomes pressurized. It's very stiff, you have a lack of mobility. And if you have negative thoughts, it's getting worse inside that suit. Hmm. So I was working with a psychiatrist to get over that problem.
Hmm. And how were you able to get over it?
Mostly by thinking positive and outside the suit.
Mm-hmm.
If you stay with your problems inside the suit, like, you know, when we work every day and we're busy, we do not think about stuff, you know? Mm-hmm. But when it's getting silent around you, you start thinking about a lot of things, and then this is where your worry starts.
It sounds like being in prison almost.
It is. I mean, it's like a prison, you know? And I started skydiving years ago when I was 16 years old because I love the freedom, you know? And now I'm like a bird in a cage.
Mm.
That's what the suit did to me.
What do you do next? I mean, are you done? Are you...
I'm going to break the speed of light. That's a joke. No, actually, I know I'm done because it's time to move on. So when I was young, when I was a little kid, I had two dreams. The first one was becoming a skydiver. The second one was becoming a helicopter pilot. I could never afford to take helicopter lessons, but I did back in 2006. At Van Nuys Airport. So now I'm a commercial helicopter pilot, and I'm gonna put my skills into public service, and I'm gonna work as a firefighter or mountain rescue helicopter pilot.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I'm still in the air, and that means this is where I want to be, and this is where I belong.
Wow. I wish you the best. It's incredible what you did.
Thank you very much.
It's really a pleasure meeting you.
It's good talking to you.
Yeah,
Thanks.
Amazing. Amazing stuff. You can see more of how Felix pulled this off on Space Dive, a documentary 5 years in the making, premieres on the National Geographic Channel Sunday, November 11th at 7 p.m. Eastern and Pacific.